squad, Leeway fam with a dude gang, it's your boy Lee John, and I'm back with another mother loving video, baby. And always remember, wake up, make your list, and start accomplishing shit, because it ain't done your way how you expect to have any leeway. Man, what's going on, family? I missed y'all, gang, it's your boy Lee John, and today's video is mostly dedicated to this, nothing else but this, today, because reason why I haven't been putting out videos, and the car was moved, the car was actually brought back not too long ago, so I was getting measurements and stuff and done, and it just started me a new job. So people want to know what's really been going on with my personal life. Personally, I'm still recovering from something else. I'm back, but I'm not back how I want to be. My main focus for the wintertime is to literally get the frame stuff done and focus on the G8. So with the Monte Carlo, basically O'Shea, I'm going to just give y'all a whole breakdown of this car only. Everything about this car only. So this video, I don't know if it'll be 6 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes. I don't know what it's going to be. But I'm going to tell y'all what the plans is and the slow grind of this car. Because this is expensive. I'm out of all the money right now. Shit, barely have anything. Share my videos and shit. Blow up. You never know what God going to bless me with. But a lot of people think it's plants and shit. And on it, nah, that's not the case. I was literally cutting down branches and stuff. So all this shit is literally under my car, which is pissing me off. But when I tell y'all, every bolt, everything is going to get touched on this car. Everything is getting touched. So to get back to the real of everything, so everybody can stop asking me questions about my car. All right, what is the plans? What is the colors? What is all this stuff that I got to go through? Now, sooner or later, I'm actually going to get a rotisserie for my upper thing. But my big plan is I have to get the frame done. Now, for people that don't know, the new color combination for the car has been decided. It's been official. I'm already getting the paint made. And I'm not changing it no more. Don't hold me to nothing. Don't try to say nothing. But this is officially, it's been official. So, I don't know if y'all can see that. That is the color of the frame. It's like a dark cranberry. Dark cranberry and lavender. Dark lavender with the rose gold is what I'm going with this car. Reason why being, mint green was good and everything, but somebody else decided to come out and do this. So, of course, everything is going to get done correctly. Even the body mounts. Everything is going to get touched on my car. I unwrapped it so we can see what's going on with it. But like I said, y'all, all this stuff that y'all see, everything is going to be done. Like, the frame's got to be notched for the 26s, of course, obviously. The wiring harness, all this stuff, like, all this stuff got to get taken off and going bye-bye for the LS swap. Like, all these wires, everything that I got in here, I'm going to order all from Mike's Monies. And it looks like this because I was cutting down the bushes and stuff. So, it literally looked like my car is in the bushes. But I just literally got it back and pushed it back. And it's obviously looked the same way. From everything in the back, everything right here from the wiring and stuff. So basically what's going on with the car is, yes, I'm still going with the 6s. People don't realize about this car, I had 4Gs for this car at first. I had 4Gs. That's why I did not get all my stuff with the Armani thing together. Because at first I wasn't going to do the two-tone or anything. I had everything decided. I was just going to go back white with this car because it actually was painted. Then I realized, I'm like, man, something didn't feel right. And when I drove the car, I said, yabba dabba fucking do. And I've seen that I had this hole in my car. So that's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on now. I can't be riding around like this. I don't care what anybody say. This is not going to happen. People can say your car been like that for months. Y'all don't understand how many shops held me up, how many people played, how many people was beating around a bush. Like, in the midst of me losing everything, I lost a lot more. Like, I'm talking about a lot, man. And this shit just became a money pit. So that's why I ended up getting this car. And this car actually going to be done next year because I already got the motor for it. And it's going to be cool with this. Like, it's like I got a car I can instantly drive after I paint it and stuff. This actually got a new paint car too. I'll get back to that later on. Like, this shit, y'all don't understand how I was 15K into this car. And just to get fucked over and shit and everything and stuff like that, then boom. 15K and a lot of money, y'all. Shit, I've been saving up that money for basically a year. And I dumped it all into this car so I could at least get it rolled ready. Had everything for the damn thing. Then I really, like, sat back and seen. I'm like, man, brakes, rotors, you know what I'm saying? All this stuff, like, so it's like, you know what? Fuck it. This is going to be the car that's going to be sitting for, and so, like I said, I get everything going. Like, I'm hustling. Right now, I got business plans. I ain't tell y'all about that. I got other stuff that I've been doing, literally, behind the scenes while I was recovering, so I can get myself together through the wintertime, so I can get my frame. Like, this is what the wintertime consists of. The wintertime consists of me getting the rotisserie and getting my frame done. I have to at least do that. I ain't worried about none of the pieces, none of the all that stuff. Look, I need my frame notch. I need to get everything together. I'm not going with the 9-inch slip no more, so I got to make sure I get the new barrel, the new everything, the side on everything now. Still going 6s. I'm not going 4s. 6s is what it is. There go my boy Mike riding around. Better be careful. So, yeah, man. So, like, dark cranberry is going to be the frame color. I'm excited about this build. And people want to know, am I still going with Magnuson and stuff like that, everything? No. I'm going with an LSA Calm Performance on a 6-0 block. L96, actually, the 4th-gen 6-0 block is way stronger, better internals, better everything that I need it for. LSA, put it on top of there, keep all the LS3 components and stuff. It ain't going to be flash important and everything and stuff. I'm going to literally have a nice, dependable motor with the supercharger sound that I like. It pop up under the hood, give me way more than enough horsepower that I need to have fun. And I have the noise and everything with the crunk music in the back. So that's what I'm going with. If you look up L96, you'll see that it's the 4th-gen iron block. I have the 3rd-gen for this one, which is a LQ4. So that's what I'm doing with this. LSA it. Like I said, I'm going to go to Speedtech. I got to get all the bracings. Like, I got to look up all the bracings and everything and stuff, so when I get everything notched, everything can get done. That's why the car is not coming off the frame, because all of this got to still get cut out so I can get it mini-tubbed and everything and stuff from the guy that I'm going to go to, so I can get everything to correct. Then he got to make sure he do my back floor. He got to do everything goes. Then this is solid. So I'm not really worried about this side, but the other side has a dent. So I want to see if somebody can get that out. If not, then I'm going to get everything goes going. Then I got to find a lot person to do a lot of metal work, man. A lot of metal work. And don't sit, oh, you got, all this shit take time and money. And money ain't something that I got right now. And I just can't just spend on the damn car. Plain and simple. Car note, getting this car done first. So that's why I'm focused on the frame. The body and everything else is literally going to come. But every bolt, every damn thing that's on this car is getting replaced. Mike's money has all types of stuff. When I mean weather stripping, everything on this car is getting redone. I'm not playing about this frame off build, and it takes time. People see, oh man, why would you just don't sell it? The car ain't going nowhere. I got this car for $2,000. I already showed the proof of that. I got this car all the way together. Now I'm rebuilding this car all the way together. This is the first car that I promised everybody I was going to rebuild. So yes, Team Imani Forge on the damn, Team of Money Forge on the 6s. Y'all already know that. Showed off them wheels too many goddamn times. It's wet right now. Yeah. Soap. This shit's so easy to rip. I gotta go get a whole new car cover, y'all. Phew. Look how easy it ripped, man. I just picked it up and I literally just ripped through it. But, yeah. So, lavender, like I said, dark lavender. If y'all don't know, like, it's a dark lavender pearl. And the dark cranberry, give it its effect. The rose gold is not going to be dark rose gold. It's going to be like the regular rose gold, not the copper, because the copper would be too light. So the regular rose gold to go well with the wheels. Already specced it out. Already got everybody dripping up on it and everything. So, like I said, I'm getting paints so I can start. But like I said, the whole frame is getting painted, and it's most definitely going to be a nice frame off build. I have the floors, so that's the other thing. Like, the car has to stay intact because I want to get the floors and I want to get the mini tubs done with the 6s so I can keep everything measured. So my next big purchase is literally making sure I have the rear rim. I'm not worried about the front. The front is actually easier to tub than the rear is, so all you got to really do is cut into that so you can get your turn of radius right and everything, then boom, you should be good on that part. This, the rear, is where it got to go. Like, got to get the new Pumpkin, Quick Performance, Speedtech parts for the bracing. Like I said, get the mini tubs on the inside. Make sure you got enough thing. The Quick Performance thing on the in the back got to get braced up, because I want everything braced. I don't care, like, anybody say, like, anything I got on this car, I want it braced, because I will be burning out. I will be having fun in this car. This car ain't just going to be babied all the damn time. It's going to be looking pretty, but I'm not about to baby the fuck out of this car. Then I got to go get, like I said, all the new weather stripping. I got to get the whole car sandblasted. I don't want to take the back mirror off, but if I'm getting the car sandblasted, it got to come off, because I don't know if there's any hidden rust back there, and I don't want to take no chances. So, yeah, T-tops got to get done. And I'm going to get the car primered all the way down. Then we're going, like I said, when we get it primered all the way down, I'm going to basically have everything set up for the swap already. I'm going to buy all that stuff for the Holley. I don't know if it's going to be Speed Tech or whatever. But I'm going, like I said, when it's off the frame and everything, the motor will be put together and stuff, dropped on there and stuff. Then everything get dialed in when the body and the frame get back together. But it's a long process. A lot of damn money that nobody really got. And it's just a headache. Frame, shade firewall. Already got the 4L80E. I'm rebuilding that. Then I'm going to get all new lines, stainless steel lines for the brakes and everything. Like, it's going to take, like, it's going to get all this top stuff that you can have for a nice, dependable car. It looks junky. It looked like this. It looked like that. I'm cool. I don't care about that. This is the ugly stages of what my car is. And a minute ago, I had to learn how to accept that. Because when I seen all that shit, I wasn't about to ride around having air coming on me, and then it was raining and stuff. Like, come on now, bro. I drove this car. I just never took a video of me driving it. Even when it was on the kickstands, I dropped it, got all the lines bled, got everything together. I drove my car. Then, boom, brought it back, because it was like, what's the point? So, there was the much updated video, like I said, y'all. It's going to be 7-inch slip. We're going to be squatting in the back like normal. I'm going to make sure I get everything done right. Whole body is going to get sprayed. Get sprayed down, sandblasted, frame off build, of course. I'm going to get everything braced and stuff before I take it off the frame, because when I do all the framework, when all the frame stuff, when the rims and stuff turn and stuff, when everything. How you doing?
Good, how's it going?
Good, good.
Hey, Velma isn't here, is she?
No, she's not.
Oh, all
right. She's going at work, I think.
Oh,
all right. All right. So, yeah. And by the way, Velma is my mother, so, yeah. Y'all, we got the business trip. So, like I said, I got Leeway merch. I got Melanated Grizzly Island merch. If you know what that is, that's my brand. I actually have my brand put out. I've been putting out videos on TikTok. So, the thing is, if y'all not following, hold on. Do this for y'all real quick. Oh, wrong phone. Hold on. So basically, this is my business page right here. On TikTok, Melanated Grizzly Island. Like I said, me as a grizzly bear. There go my polar bear. There go my mood swinging panda. Like, you know, you got a chill version. Because a panda is the most, like, a lot of people like the panda. So I got two of them just for mood changing. Then last night, I released the koala bear. So, like, I got 10 bears all together. I'm getting ready for my brand and stuff. Then on top of that, I'm trying to get other stuff done. So, like, that is going to lead me on and help me out so I can build my cars. Because I actually miss getting back to my cars. So, get the complete breakdown again, y'all. Yes, we LSA swapping the car. We got the one. I'm going to actually go pick up the block soon so I can get everything fixed. I'm debating about pro charging this one. So the Pro Charger is actually cheap, cheaper than turbos and crap. I'm thinking about Pro Charging it. I don't want no big Pro Charger. I just want something that'll make that noise wind up, and I can still be able to have everything going to the back. It's deciding on that. But I want this, like, this one is literally getting taught, like, small parts and stuff again put together for this car as we speak. I still got to get the V6 taken out. So the interior parts, I'm going back with the OG interior, honest to God truth. I'm just going to go up to Cleveland. I'm only an hour from Cleveland, so I'm gonna go down to Cleveland, go see my boy because he's driving his car. Go get these seats and stuff. Then I gotta go to the interior shops and start looking at the colors when the paint get here. Like when the paint things get here, and I wanna see if she can send me a paint chip. So I'ma ask her about that. Can she paint a paint chip of each paint on a chip and send it with the paint? If she could do that for me, I'd be happy. I'm gonna be most definitely happy if she can send me the paint with the paint chips inside the box. So I'ma make sure I inbox her on that. It'll save me from having to get it sprayed out, and it'll save me on a lot of stuff. So I'm gonna see. Like I said, I need to get this color sprayed out, because technically I can tell y'all about that. This is actually going a candy pearl Rosetta, so it's like a dark pearl with a candy effect sports car. The other color was sexy as fuck, but the darker tone with what I'm doing for this, outrageous. It's gonna make this car look way better. So rose gold been my thing, so I'm gonna stick with it on both of my cars until, like I said, we gonna focus on the projects. This been my baby, three-row vehicle, always been good. That's my daily, but that's it, y'all. We gonna get the paint. When we shade the firewall, get everything with the firewall done. I'm gonna have this mug sitting on some stuff. Firewall gonna get the paint. Everything that can get painted that I can paint without me having to do stuff, yeah, it'll get touched, it'll get painted. Then we gonna be wrapping stuff up. Like, this gonna take me about 2-3 years. But like I said, I got my blessings coming, and I'm starting business stuff, so you never know what could happen. So I'm gonna keep my eyes open, and I'm gonna keep my prayers open. I'm gonna keep my hard work ethic going, because you never know what God can bless you with. And boom, if I get my break, most definitely, I'm going to be done way faster. But I'm still going to want my time to be taken out. But I already got the scheme and everything that I want to do. So the platform for this is solidified now. I already got everything set up for that. The color, everything is already solidified. I'm not changing it no more. This literally is going to be what it's going to be. I'm not changing nothing about that. So that's solidified too. Stamp, paint man already got the front bumper. He already waiting for the paint to get there so he can paint the bumper. I'm not changing it no more. So Meliana O'Shea, this is the big update that y'all wanted. I know I didn't get in depth how I wanted to, but it is what it is. Your boy just tired, and I haven't put out a video in a month because I've been focused on other things. And I've been growing in other ways. So most definitely, O'Shea gonna go, Meliana, JJ, side piece, and that's how we're gonna do it. Love y'all. Y'all be safe, but this is your boy Lee John, and I'm checking out with another mother loving video, baby. Y'all be blessed and safe out here.